are not allowed to use border borders.
The Leadership Code Act empowers the Inspectorate of Government to receive and examine the declaration of leaders and public servants, including their income, assets and liabilities. The Inspectorate continues to sensitize the leaders on the faster declaration of their income, assets and liabilities through the online declaration system that was launched in March this year.
Once we receive these declarations, we are mandated to conduct investigations to verify their accuracy.
The declaration period for civil servants will end on 7th of August, while the elected leaders have until 14th August. There is punitive action for leaders who fail to comply.
And we are expecting 400,000 public officers to declare during this period. And already, over 100,000 public leaders have already registered on to the IGODS. You are liable to a warning, demotion, dismissal, and vacation of office.
Vice President Jessica Lupo says government is determined to fight corruption this time.
It completely deters devolvement and derails the implementation of government programs and service delivery.
She has asked the public to stop demanding a lot from their leaders, as this could lead them into corruption.
Stop tempting the public officers with the thinking that the public officers must amass wealth, which is even unexplained. Wealth is good, but let's work for it.
The last exercise for declaration of assets was held in 2019. Juma Kidia, NTV.